step up in this bitch like, I'm the one your bitch like. Yeah, I'm the one your bitch like. And I be talking shit like, I ain't scared to lose a fist fight. And she grabbing on my like, she wanna see if it.
So, barbering. I didn't actually, I got into hairdressing first. When I was 19, I joined Coco Blue in Truro. Done an apprenticeship in hairdressing, 2 year apprenticeship. Soon realised I didn't like hairdressing. I used to do men even when I was doing hairdressing, and much preferred doing like barbering, even though I was in a hair salon. And then later on, I veered off to barbering about 5 years ago now. Yeah, I use social media. I use Instagram and Facebook. Facebook's amazing. Like, I swear Facebook's brought me 50% of probably the people that come to this shop, because they see cuts, they like the cut, they want to know, right, where's that done, they see where it's done, and then they come here, they message you. You know, if I didn't ever do Instagram or Facebook, you're not really getting your work out there. Obviously, word of mouth's a good one for it. I haven't advertised in papers or, you know, like, I'm paid for, you know, companies to advertise me in gyms or anything like that. Like, all you do, it's just literally word of mouth, reputation, and Facebook. I think Facebook's the best tool for anything. Like, using a page, you can promote your post. I did that once and it brought in so many people. But like I said, it's mainly just from uploading photos of haircuts, and that does the talking, you know what I mean? People see the haircut, like the haircut, and then they want to know what's done, and next thing they're in the door. So, yeah, it's fantastic.
Vibes is the only thing we giving out. Oh, you say that you feeling it. Haters didn't get the invite, huh? But I bet that they hearing this. Making noise off the Richter. Kodak lifestyle, you better take a picture. Magazine centerfolds, now I'm thinking bigger. Fuck the average Joe, boy, you know I'm trying to differ. And so far I think I'm doing it. Anything is possible, and boy, I think I'm proving it. People looking up to me, I'm really kinda new to this. Yeah, they looking up to me, I'm really kinda new to this. I got their hands to the ceiling. Boy, it's indescribable, I can't explain this feeling. My life's so appealing, cause boy, I'm living for right now. All you people wearing suits, better pipe down. Rest.
If I found a way to be happy every day, if you could just see my face, y'all would see I'm smiling. The clouds are never gray. If only there was a place. If you could just see my face, then y'all would see I'm smiling. If I found a way to be happy every day, if you could just see my face, y'all would see I'm smiling. The clouds are never gray. If only there was a place. If you could just see my face, then y'all would see I'm smiling.
Influencers, so most people would normally say, like, you know, well-known famous people, but not me really. I'm my ex-boss, actually, Eddie Cannon. Like, he's where it all started for me. Like, I've met him 4 years ago, worked for the men's room, and that 4 years he taught me so much about everything. He taught, you know, I wasn't even a barber when I met him as a hairdresser, so he taught me barbering. And basically everything I needed to know in business to do with barbering is just brilliant. So yeah, he's a big influence for me.
Don't try to change me in any way. You don't own me.